that leads to glory, Jesus' motto. Well, it's been a mouthful all week, and I pray that you have received a word from the Lord, you've received instruction, you've received insight, revelation, and understanding. Beloved, these are trying times. That's why God has me preaching this message. I know my brother lost his only son and only child, who was 33 years old. We saw a father bury two daughters in one day. People are dying. People are going through, you know, business reversals, foreclosures, all kinds of things today. Beloved, it's one thing to go through a gut-wrenching experience. It's another to go through it humbly before the Lord your God. That's what Jesus modeled for us. And today we're enjoying the blessing and the glory the Father gave him because of that humility. We are benefiting from his sacrifice. Do you know that it is the same pattern that when we go through our thing and we qualify with the Lord, so many people get blessed who are coming behind us, who are under our covering, whether we are parents or preachers or leaders or teachers or mentors, it doesn't matter where you are. You will experience the same glory coming to you and through you to bless other people. Hallelujah. Let me read Jesus' glory in Philippians chapter 2. The Bible says, "And being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross." It's amazing. I remember once some of these ignorant people, they read so much, homeless. We're going to the homeless shelter, but these guys are so well studied. They read everything but the Bible. And when they read the Bible, they read it in the light of the books they have read. I said, why don't you use these things for more productive ends in your life? The guy came to challenge me and saying that the Bible said that Jesus was crucified on a tree. And why are you guys preaching that he was crucified on the cross? And he said there were 21 types of trees or crosses that the Romans used to crucify people at the time, trying to show off what he has read somewhere. I said, does it really matter whether he was crucified on a tree or on a cross? I said, is that the issue? I said, the issue is, have you received what he did? Whether he was a tree or cross. Yes, if you read the gospel, say, well, you know, it was a tree, but here Paul said it was a cross. What does it matter? It says, even the death of the cross. The Romans used crosses. It's you know, even Josephus documents these things. So there's nothing to worry about. But look at the blessing is what I want to get to today. Wherefore, God also hath highly exalted him. Highly exalted him. And given him a name which is above every name. Glory to God. I want you to see that glory, that blessing. Highly exalted. He says he was exalted higher than the heavens. I keep telling people the throne of God is higher than the heavens itself. That even after we get to heaven, we still have to look up to the throne. Wow. He said he set his glory above the heavens, the Bible says. But watch this. He gave him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow. I've always made this distinction. The reason it says should bow is because if your character and nature does not qualify, when you speak his name, it does not carry the power, and demons will largely ignore you. Somebody was giving me a testimony today. They went on a missionary journey to India, he and his daughter. Said they returned to London, and while they were in England, the daughter started getting sick. They could see the patterns of malaria. And he called a Nigerian brother in England, who is a preacher, and asked him for help to get the daughter to the hospital, because the doctors they called on the phone said they needed to get her to the hospital. Unfortunately, they went, I guess, proverbially by faith, and did not take the malaria, anti-malaria drugs. So a malaria can kill very quickly. So the preacher says, I'm not going to take you to the hospital. I'm going to cast out the spirit of malaria from her. He said, amazingly, he wasn't really interested in that. But he said, this man came and commanded the spirit of malaria to leave this woman's body. And beloved, he said it happened. And the daughter just recovered instantly. You see, they used the name of Jesus because they qualified and it worked. It's a should bow. In other words, if you meet the standard, the result will be this. If you don't, you will be largely ignored. And most believers are largely ignored today. There's no decree they make in Jesus' name that comes to pass. But beloved, when you're a son of God, when you're living for the Lord, when you make corrections, you know, in your life, God will honor you. Watch this. It says that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth. See, that's where hell is, under the earth. People go to hell temporarily, but eternally is the lake of fire. Hell itself will be thrown in the lake of fire. You need to understand that. So when we preach to people about going to hell eternally, that's not really, really accurate. Hallelujah. He says, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of the Father. That's why I'm telling people from false religions. It's either you do it right here on earth, or you do it after you die. But you must confess Him as Lord. Thank God we know Him. Thank God He has modeled the way into glory for us. Would you take the bait? Would you follow? I've brought the word to you. May God give you victory in Jesus' name. Amen. We love you. We'll see you next week.